Akwaba, my beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. It's Melin Mishi. It has been a hot minute, guys. I'm not even gonna stunt. You know when you're like not doing anything but a lot is happening at the same time? That was me for the last month, but I thought we would touch base as to what I've been up to in a future video. But today I'm just gonna show you guys all of the products that I've been using as it's been getting a little bit colder now here in London. If you have any kind of skin sensitivity, you know that going from different seasons, from summer to autumn to winter, it just messes our skin barrier up. Like, so these are the products that have been keeping my skin in check. The duo that I'm using at the moment is my Foreo Luna Me 2 and the Fresh Beauty Soy Cleanser. If you haven't tried this combo, this is an unsponsored video. Like, genuinely, I love these products. And the way that this cleanser and this cleansing brush make my skin feel after I'm done, I already know I'm gonna have a good skin day. I'm going in with my Laneige Sleeping Mask. This is an OG product as well. I really enjoy it. It just makes my skin on my lips super supple and soft. Again, if you followed me for any period of time, you know that I've mentioned this product before and I still use it, so yeah. Going in with the rose water and just spritzing it all over my face. I find that when I start with a slightly moist base, it just allows my products to sit a lot better. This, now, if there's one product that I think has transformed my skincare routine this winter, it is this serum by Fresh Beauty. So it's the Rose Deep Hydration Oil Infused Serum. On the weeks when I don't use this, I can literally notice the difference. It just provides such a deep nourishment to the skin. It is pretty spenny, so I would definitely recommend like grabbing some samples and giving it a try first, but honestly, this product bangs. Rubbing that into my skin in circular motions and just get the blood pumping. It's good to give your face a little pat down, get the capillaries open and get the ingredients working. I've been suffering a little bit with hyperpigmentation, so I'm actually trying this new vitamin C serum by Medicube. They sent it to me. This is the first time I used it. It kind of smelled funky, but anyway. This is AHC's cream for eye and face. You can see I'm almost done because I love this product. It's very moisturizing, really calming, really firming, and it doesn't irritate my sensitive eyes. And just a quick tip, any excess products that you have on your fingers, just work it down your neck because that's where you show the first signs of aging. This Fresh Rose Hydrating Cream reminds me of the creams that I used to use back in the day when I went to Korea. It just gives you like a different level of hydration throughout the entire day. I really, really enjoy this cream. Again, it is a little bit more spenny, but it is worth trying out. Most products these days come in travel sizes or sample sizes, so you can always give it a try before you buy. This is the facial oil that I'm using by Neil's Remedy. I love this. Like, when I don't use it, I notice that my skin is a lot more dull, so I have been using it in my routine. This is the eyebrow pomade by Refi. There's not a product like this on the market, I feel. I'm pretty sure the product was made by an influencer on Instagram, but she really did something. And I've been using this very sparingly because I've only got one at the moment and I really enjoy it. It just gives you that kind of laminated brow effect without having to laminate your brows, so that's great. And at this point, I completely forgot to put on SPF. Not gonna lie, it was later in the day, so I wasn't planning to put it on. But at this point, you can obviously put SPF on as well and you'd be good to go. I actually filmed this video when I was having a bit of an eczema flare up, which is pretty normal for me, so just want to show you guys this is normal skin. Everybody has lumps, bumps, texture, but that's the fun part of skincare, just tailor creating it to what suits your routine, what works for you. And as I stayed consistent, within a few days, as you guys can see in this clip, my skin was already looking a lot better, still a bit of texture but not as much. And about a week later in this clip, my skin was looking scrumptious, if I can say so myself. Blemish wear, pimple wear. My skin was looking good, obviously with makeup, but even without. So yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. If you have a similar skin type to me, let me know if you try out any of these products and how you get on with those. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.